Right now, I'm going to cut across to our deputy editor, Shiv Arora, who's joining us live from the India Today Global Roundtable. Over to you, Shiv.
Well, thanks very much, Sanjana. Copies of the India Today magazine with the cover, exclusive interview with US President Barack Obama, the only interview that he has given to an Indian media agency, to India Today, just a couple of days before he arrives in the country as India's national guest on the Republic Day celebrations. It's covered a huge gamut of issues, and here at the Global Roundtable, I can tell you that everyone's had a chance to look through that interview. Exhaustive statements that have been made, a lot of different sentiments that have been expressed, but enough from me. Let's listen in to some of the people who've been here, who've listened to some of the things that have been said by the many experts and analysts who've not only had a chance to speak about what they think can be expected from the Obama visit this time around, but also had a chance to look at the interview itself that President Barack Obama has given to the India Today group. With me is senior leader of the BJP, political commentator and columnist Seshadri Chari. Mr. Chari, thanks very much for being here with us on this a moment of pride for the India Today group that President Obama has given us this interview. Has touched upon several topics, including some catchphrases that have been used before: natural allies, defining partnership of the 21st century. Are these are these just catchphrases, Mr. Chari, do you think, or are they based on something very real that we can expect when the president comes?
No, I think the Indo-US relationship is an ongoing process. It has it's a growth curve. We have had bad times, we have had good times also. And obviously, in those times, some phrases get frozen.
Yes.
In the minds of people and in the narratives of both the countries. But I think now is the time when these phrases are assuming meanings.
Yes.
So when the US president says that Indo-US relationship is turning into a working strategic partnership, they really mean it.
Mm.
And it is happening.
Yes.
On earlier occasions, when US said partnership, the meaning of the word partnership was very different to the US and very different to the Indians. Another important aspect of Indo-US relationship as of now, after the Modi government came into power, is that even with the US, we are dealing with them from a position of strength.
Yes.
From a position of confidence.
So we're equal partners. Some people would disagree. Some would disagree that it's an equal partnership. But even though President Obama in this interview does talk about being equal partners.
Correct. I mean, when President Obama says equal partnership, he realizes the undertones of what he actually means.
Yes.
Because if you look at the gamut of economic growth trajectory that India has under Modi.
Yes.
And if you see the world circumstances, the scenario, I think we are now turning from a billion economy to a trillion economy.
Right.
So when we do that, when we cross the Rubicon, as they say,
yes,
it's going to be a huge release of energy.
Yes.
An economic energy.
Yes.
And that is what India and US are all both looking at.
Mr. Chari, a lot is being said, and even President Obama has touched upon this in his interview to us, where he talks about the personal cordial relations between the two individuals, President Barack Obama and Prime Minister Modi. We've seen it on more than one occasion. We've seen it last September in the United States. We saw it in Myanmar as well, very briefly. There is a human
obviously
in compatibility between these two world leaders, which is not being missed by the people.
No, in most of the international relationships,
yes,
the personal equations that leaders build become very important.
Yes.
It's always there. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't happen. And this personal equation brings in a very new dimension in the relationship.
Yes.
And I think the understanding of Modi by the US establishment,
yes,
has played an important part in this whole story. Now, the same was not the case 4 years back or 5 years back. That was also not the case, that kind of personal bonding between Barack Obama and say Manmohan Singh.
Yes.
And to be very fair to our former Prime Minister, Barack Obama had a lot of respect and regard for Dr. Manmohan Singh.
Yes.
As an economist.
But it wasn't the same kind of chemistry, you're saying.
But that respect and regard is different from the kind of chemistry that is existing between Barack Obama and Narendra Modi as of now.
Would you say that the relationship, the kind of interplay between Manmohan Singh and Barack Obama was more like a teacher-student kind of relationship rather than being friends in this case?
Yeah, you can use any phrase.
Yes.
But that was the relationship. The kind of relationship that existed between them,
yes,
was different. And that had its own limitations.
Yes.
That limitation was, as I said earlier, he had great trust and faith in Dr. Manmohan Singh.
Yes.
But he did not think, the Americans really did not think, that Dr. Manmohan Singh would be able to transform that relationship into a permanent country-to-country relationship.
Which you're saying is going to be possible.
Which is now existing in the case
of one final question, Mr. Achary. Symbolism is there, the friendship is there, you know, the catchphrases are there, the good personal equation between President Obama and Prime Minister Modi is there. Do you, though, believe that there is enough on the table between the two countries to actually have some kind of deliverable? At the end of the day, the people of India, the United States, will want to see something concrete taking place, sir.
Absolutely, absolutely. I fully agree. That is exactly what I was trying to say. That in spite of all this friendship and equality and magnanimity on both the sides and all this understanding on two sides, the personal equation of both the leaders, ultimately how we are able to take the opportunity and proceed further is going to be very important.
Right.
And it's much easier as far as India is concerned, because we have another 4.5 years for this government,
yes,
to really put all these things that is in ink between USA and India to practice.
Right.
But whereas there could be a change in the dispensation in the US post-2016.
Okay.
Which means we will have to not only deal with Barack Obama and the Democrats, we should also pave the way for dealing with whoever is the next dispensation,
right,
whoever is the next president, and that will come only when we put into practice,
okay,
what we have achieved now.
Okay, thank you very much, Sashashari, for speaking to us. A great deal on the table. There are those, within the ruling party, commentators, observers who believe that there's definitely enough substantially on the table between India and the United States to move this simply beyond catchphrases. President Obama touches upon some of those issues in this interview to India Today. He talks about counterterrorism, he talks about investment, he talks about infrastructure and education, which will be really the underpinnings of the relationship moving forward. Remember, Sanjana, that when President Obama is here, India and the United States will be renewing a 10-year new framework agreement on defense cooperation. Now, that is not any small potatoes. We're talking about not just billions of dollars of defense deals, we're also talking about a huge, you know, an expansive cooperation framework between both these countries, moving forward in the strategic space, in the nuclear space, in several other fields as well. There are sticking points, there are some stumbling blocks, but at the end of the day, there is a firm belief, and I think there is a consensus, that the personal equation between President Obama and Prime Minister Modi, as well as consensus that things are generally on track, means that the only way from here is up.
Shiv Arora, Deputy Editor, bringing us that. Thank you so much from the India Today Global Roundtable.